mature woodland home to an assortment of wildlife and the final resting place for hundreds of people. Graves are spread out in circles around trees, and all of the memorials are made out of wood. The man who set it up is Nick Taylor, a former funeral director.
Man has a very close affinity with woodland. It does, after all, provide us with our shelter, our fuel, our tools and our food. Therefore, and also, woodlands have the cycle of life. It has all the seasons there. It's very apparent that there is new life every spring. And that's immensely reassuring to people. We find we get visitors who just like the peace of being able to walk through a beautiful woodland and to resolve issues maybe, or to remember someone. It's just a lovely environment in which to do that.
The park is for people of all religions and beliefs and all ages.
Well, it was actually my local hospital that put me in touch with the woodland. I lost a baby in 2004, and I didn't feel I would want her buried in a conventional graveyard. I did look at a couple, but they were just so cold and unfeeling, and it just wasn't what I had in mind. And then as soon as I came in here, it just felt so right. It felt like the right place to have her laid to rest. In the woodland, in such a natural environment and a beautiful setting.
When a family first comes here to visit, we will, if they wish, we will walk around the wood with them, and they get a feel for the wood. And some families want to be near the bluebells, or some families want a plot on top of the hill, or you know, under a beech tree or something. They'll have their own desires about where is right for them. We do not carry out the whole funeral ourselves. We work closely with funeral directors, and we support them in their job, because we feel that they're expert in that side of it and we're expert in our side, and the two combined hopefully will be a much enhanced bereavement experience for families, and a very positive one.
Bereaved families can also choose what is right for them.
I suppose the thing that most people tend to obviously realise that we do is to carry out a burial as a normal cemetery would. A lot of people don't realise that they can have the service here as well in the Woodland Hall. But you don't have to do that. You can have the service elsewhere and then come for the burial. Or you can have the service here and then go elsewhere for the cremation. So lots of different options that people can do, and a lot of people don't realise that. They can have the service when they inter the ashes, or they can scatter the ashes, or you can have everything here.
Children's activities, dawn chorus walks and picnics are also held here throughout the year.
It's very much a place where life goes on. It isn't a dismal place where you just come to say goodbye to your loved ones. It's a place where people love to visit, they bring their families. We have a tea shop on a Sunday, so people come and they meet other people. We do a lot of children's events through the school holidays. We have Easter egg hunts, and we've got a pond dipping platform up at the far end of the wood. We did a teddy bears picnic in the summertime, and it's just lovely. It is really a place where life goes on, where children come and visit, where families feel comfortable. We had one little boy whose granny's buried here, and he made his nest box and then took it down to his granny's plot to show her and talk about what he'd been doing. And it's just lovely that it's acceptable for him to do that and to talk about it. Death isn't something that's been hidden away from him.
The cycle of life is something that touches all religions, or those with no religion at all. The cycle of life is something we live with. We see the different seasons of the year. And I think even for children who love coming to places like this, you know, even if it's just to kick the leaves or throw conkers at the squirrels, the cycle of life reminds us that life goes on. It's a very positive thing.